just embarrassed myself. As the title of this video suggests, this is Epic Arm Day.
To do a collab with a guy I met in the gym back in 2015. We've been friends since 2015. And over the years, I've seen he has a passion just like I do in the gym. He kills his goals and taking care of himself. The funny thing is, I was a personal trainer and he worked in the other position in the gym. And fast forward to now, we linked up. He called me and said, "Do you want to work out?" And I was like, "Does a sheep buy? Does a bear like meat?" You know what I'm saying? I was like, "Oh, sure, let's go ahead. Let's do our thing." So we linked up. We decided we was going to train arms. And I said, "Hey, let me put a project on YouTube with it." And he was down with it. And here we go. So we kicked it off with a few stretches. And Carlos reminded me of the importance of stretch. I gotta throw stretching back in my routine, but it's very critical that you should stretch, not just before and after the workout, but you should stretch all during the day. Your body needs to get stretched. You're getting tight, you're getting stiff as we age, so you need to stretch and keep your body in check that way. And stretch many ways as possible. Be looking forward to a program coming out by me.
We got arms today, about to go hard. This beast right here, this Kylo. Arm day, stay tuned.
I'm not sure the name of this exercise, but this challenges the triceps. This hits the triceps, and notice how my hands are closer together. The closer your hands are, the harder this exercise is gonna be. But it's really effective to target the triceps. And your abs have to stiffen up. Real good exercise. Now, he explained to me how this was his first time doing this exercise ever. And it was challenging for him. You see, he spread his hands out to make it easier. And when you spread your hands out, it hits the shoulders a little bit more. But as you can see, his triceps are still working. You know, we are targeting the tricep muscle, so make sure your triceps are working and you're getting a good push in. They should burn, go all the way down and all the way up. And, you know, make sure you hit those triceps for a good burn. You can notice that my arms are a little bit further apart this time. My hands are further apart. It's easier. And it's more of a pushing motion. But you want to hit your triceps. The closer your hands are, the more tricep involvement you have. So try this at home. A lot of guys neglect the tricep. So we decided to start with the tricep and show them a little love in a different way. And as you notice, this exercise isn't used often. So I decided to start off with this first. It's a real good burner. As you can see, you don't need equipment. All you have to do is practice getting real low. Get your head under the bench if you can. This is about my third set, and as you can see, it's getting tough. My hands are back inside again. So this is a lot of work on the tricep. The triceps handle a lot of the weight, so it's harder. When you spread out, the shoulders get a little bit more of the weight, so try to keep your hands close to hit the triceps more effectively.
It's time to get that work in. Let's go.
The triceps and biceps are antagonistic muscle groups. So the biceps and triceps are kind of working against each other. So it's good to hit them at the same time. Plus, we're confusing the body by hitting the arms. You know, I don't hit the arms that much, so I was excited about this training exercise, but I'm hitting the biceps with the arm blaster. This arm blaster makes the bicep work more. So you should try this I'll try to have the link in the description for the arm blast. Go. It's a real good exercise for the bicep muscle and the forearms. The arm blaster puts more of an isolation on the bicep muscle, and we're using both arms at the same time, so you're burning, you're metabolizing a lot more calories because both arms are going at the same time, and it kind of forces the bicep to work more, so it's a little bit more strenuous on the bicep, which is the idea. We're training the bicep muscle. You want them to grow, you want them to improve, so that's why the arm blaster is so crucial.
We got a tricep next. Gonna hit the triceps. Pull down. Got these in the back arms. They call them back arms. Alright.
As I said before, this is arm day. You know, we're hitting the triceps and the biceps, and notice. Now we're hitting the triceps. We're using the rope pull down for a tricep pull down. And notice my forearms is working. You can see I'm kind of vascular, and you can see some of my striations in my arm. I'm kind of lean here. So you want to make sure your triceps are working. Keep your knees slightly bent. And you want that horseshoe on your tricep where your tricep is. That's the target muscle. Okay, it's Carlos's turn. He's still got tricep pull down. Using the triceps, you're trying to isolate the tricep muscle and make them work by themselves, if that's possible. But we know that's not possible. But rewind that back. You gotta look at this man's striations in his arms, you know. This is a testament to his diet. This really shows you that his diet is right, and he gets it in as in the gym, as you can see. Nice job with your diet. Nice job with your body. You real lean, Carlos. This is what we shoot for. This is what we aim for. This is why we spend hours in the gym doing what we love.
We go hard in here, man. You got to make them arms work. You got to try effort all day long, baby.
So next, we decide to switch it up and do the reverse of the tricep pull down. We're doing bicep rope pulls to the face. You know, you're working the biceps. I'm holding it to get that squeeze at the top. You're not supposed to do exercises quickly. You gotta have your muscles face time under tension, and that's what I'm doing right here. Next, we got Carlos. He's doing the same thing. You know, you wanna slow your reps down, and you wanna make sure your muscles are working, and you want your muscles to feel what you're doing. You get growth and you get change from time under tension. So always slow your reps down and make them count so you can get the best for your work. You know, you don't want to just go through the motion. I just wanted to say, it's like we instantly connected, man. We knew we both had work to do and we just got it done. You know, we didn't talk about reps and, oh, this is too hard. We just went to work. Right here, we doing tricep extensions over the head. These are skull crushers with dumbbells. You know, I'm keeping my arms above my head. I'm trying to, and I'm making my triceps work. We got the triceps again, and this is a real effective exercise. Carlos has a shoulder injury. He said the other variation bothers his shoulder, so he did it seated. Overhead tricep extensions, and this does the same thing. We targeting the tricep muscles, and as you can see, the weight is kind of heavy and you're gonna struggle, so this builds strength in the tricep. I'm gonna be honest, a lot of the stuff I do in the gym is because I try to get creative. I try to do different things that challenge my body, and this is no different. I never see anyone doing this, but I know it works my tricep muscles. That's why I'm doing it right here. And you get a good pump, and it's hitting my tricep muscle. So, I don't know what this is called. I just do it because I feel my triceps working, and they are. Okay, Carlos wanted to do another set of tricep extensions. As you can see, the work accumulates. You know, you want to go to the gym, and you want to get tons of work in every day. Hit your body parts, make your muscles work, and they should feel it, and you should work and grow and repeat, and you will have aesthetic physique. Hey, So we ain't come to play. We went back to the arm blast.
Damn.
And we did single arm dumbbell curls, you know.
Damn.
It's a good way to isolate the bicep muscles again. This time we ain't using the double grip. We're doing single arm. Nice right there. You get a good, real good pump. And you get to isolate that muscle group even further. So doing single arm bicep curls, you get to isolate the muscle further. And when you do two hands together, you can on your total strength. So
that protein, baby.
Always keep that in mind.
Damn.
Somehow we didn't get footage of the arm blasters for the dumbbell curls for Carlos. But anyway, we're on to the next exercise. This is the incline. No, this is the regular bench press with the barbell. And we're having our grip closer. His hands are closer together. The closer your hands are, the more triceps involvement you get. So that's what we're targeting here. And this is the finisher. This is towards the end of our training session. And as you can see, he's not struggling, but it's challenging to him. And he's kind of winded. Now it's my turn. Okay, before I even get started, watch my hands. Look at my hands, how they're close together. And watch what happened. They fell. The weight fell on me because my hands are too close together. So it's important that your hands are close together at the start, but not too close, or this will happen.
I just embarrassed myself.
Okay, retake. This is take two. You see my hands are a little bit further apart and I'm able to push through my wrist up and down. And you can see it's a little bit challenging even though the weight is not heavy at all. This is 135 pounds, but we're trying to hit the triceps. That's why the weight is fairly light and I'm able to do it this time. It was a pretty high volume workout. We did a lot of exercises. A lot of the clips we didn't even include in this video. We did a lot of work and we finished with cardio. Make sure you get your cardio sessions in. Did about 20 minutes on the Stairmaster. I didn't record that also. But a lot of work, a lot of training. You gotta beat your body into shape, literally. Get some work in. So that concludes my epic arm day video. And as you can see towards the end there, I had made a mistake on that tricep press. And we was hitting the triceps right there at the end. That's another arm exercise you can do at home. But I got too close and my wrist kind of buckled on me and the weight came down on my chest. So it's something to learn about, you know. You know, the weight wasn't too heavy. It just was an awkward position for me. But anyway, if you like the video, I do projects like this all the time. Hit the subscribe button now and hit the bell notification button to be notified every time I release a video. And you can also join me on Facebook. I have a Facebook group called Justin Parks Training. You can get in my atmosphere, get in my ecosystem so you can lose weight, put on muscle, do whatever your fitness goals are. Don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to share it with your friends. And hit me up at justinparkstraining@gmail.com if you have any questions about meal plans or macro programs or my much anticipated 3-day split routine program coming real soon. Hit me up. Hope you enjoyed the video. Stay lean. Hit them arms. And I'm going to see you next time. Thanks for watching.
Godzilla ain't got shit on me, nigga. My mama ain't raised no hoe.